glad to be here today and happy to be talking to everyone about polyphenols. In particular, we're going to talk about the key role that they play in neurogenesis. Once again, I'm Brenda Fonseca, Senior Technical Service Manager with Kemin Health. What we're going to talk about today is I'll give you a brief overview of polyphenols and where they are, where you can find them in plants in particular. Then we'll dive into a specific plant source, and then we'll talk about that specific plant and how it could be impacting neurogenesis. And I'll wrap up by giving you two specific studies that have looked at that and to see, you know, how actually these key polyphenols could actually increase neurogenesis or the rate of new neuron growth in the brain. So let's go ahead and dive right in. So polyphenols are potent molecules that are found in plants, sometimes referred to as phytomolecules. I'm sure you are familiar with some of these sources. There are actually over 8,000 varieties of polyphenols, so they're quite prevalent, and they have some really powerful human health benefits. And primarily one is that's well known is their antioxidant benefits. So you may be familiar with polyphenols such as anthocyanins that come from blueberries as one source, or perhaps resveratrol from red wine, flavanols from cocoa. Those are maybe some better known sources for polyphenols. But the one that I want to focus on that you might not be as aware of is polyphenols that are found in spearmint. For example, rosmarinic and salvinolic acids are two distinct and powerful polyphenols that maybe are lesser known but have some great science behind them. And those are polyphenols that you can find from spearmint. So we can talk about that. And so let me explain to you maybe one reason why you might not be as familiar as the polyphenols that are coming from spearmint is that typically when we use spearmint, and especially in a commercial sense, we're looking at the right side of the screen here, and we are harvesting spearmint for the oil. So using a steam distillation technique and looking for those molecules that really give it that minty flavor like the carvone. But actually what we've done here at Kemin is we've taken the spearmint and we're harvesting it for those polyphenols. To get those polyphenols out, we need to use a water extraction process. And by doing that technique, as well as the unique drying technology that's been developed, we're able to preserve and get an extract that's full of these very powerful polyphenols, such as rosmarinic acid, salvinolic acid, and lithospermic acid. These molecules actually have amazing science for their potential benefit in brain health, and that's what attracted us to the spearmint to begin with. And we are very interested in understanding how these polyphenols can help clinically and with the mechanistic improvements that we see for overall brain health. So Kemin has developed a very unique line of spearmint. It's a purpose-grown spearmint. It's something that takes a long time to develop. So this spearmint was developed over the course of at least 7 years. And we have found that with this spearmint, we've completed a full phytochemical characterization. So that was both quantitative and qualitative, conducted in association with the University of Parma. And from that characterization, we were able to identify that there were over 50 polyphenols found in the spearmint. To give you an example of one of those key polyphenols, we find that in the Kemin grown spearmint, there's over 100 milligrams of rosmarinic acid per gram of the spearmint plant. When you look at a commercial spearmint, so if you just went to your backyard or went out to a farm growing spearmint for the toothpaste or the mouthwash, there's going to be a big range of the amount of polyphenols found in that spearmint. And so, for example, if you looked at just rosmarinic acid in commercial spearmint, you might find that the commercial spearmint has anywhere between 6 to 50 milligrams of rosmarinic acid per gram. So a much different type of a characteristic that you and profile that you would see in commercial spearmint. So when you are looking at this this Kemin purpose-grown spearmint, now we can see a spearmint that is very high in these distinct molecules and these polyphenols. And so now we have taken it to the next step here at Kemin to understand what are the clinical benefits that we would see with this. So we've we've seen cognitive clinical benefits, and understanding then what are some of those underlying mechanisms has led us into the studies that have specifically related to neurogenesis. So let's back up for 1 second and understand what we mean when we say neurogenesis. So what neurogenesis is it's the growth of new neurons in the brain. So previously the thought was you get what you get and you have no new neurons after birth. But actually in the last 15 to 20 years, the science has really well established that as adults, healthy adults, we do continue to grow new neurons throughout our lifespan. For the most part, we grow the neurons in a specific area of the brain called the hippocampus. This is an area that's extremely important for learning and memory. It helps us with spatial guidance, navigation, recognizing patterns. So it's a really key area for our cognition. And in general, it seems that on average, an adult grows probably somewhere around 1,400 new neurons each day. However, that there's things that affect it. So, for example, if we exercise, it has been shown that you can increase that rate of neurogenesis. And then on the other side, if you are not getting enough sleep, if you're stressed, those types of things tend to decrease neurogenesis. So we see how there is an impact on this. So why should we care? You know, what role does neurogenesis play in our daily cognition? And what we have found is that neurogenesis is very important for some key aspects of cognition, in particular learning and memory, as well as mood. So on the learning and memory research, it's shown that neurogenesis is very helpful for those areas that I said the hippocampus plays a role in, such as spatial navigation, pattern recognition. And animal studies have shown that when neurogenesis is blocked, these areas of learning and memory are greatly impacted. At the same time, neurogenesis seems to be important for mood. So antidepressants, for example, have been found to increase rates of neurogenesis, as well as in animal studies, it's been found that if neurogenesis is blocked, those antidepressants no longer have a significant impact. And so neurogenesis is really important for us as healthy adults. It's something that we want to maintain. And so here at Kemin, we are very interested in understanding, are there some specific molecules that also could be used to help maintain a healthy level of neurogenesis in adults? And so that's where we developed this experiment and where some of the existing science as well as our own science has supported that role. So there is quite a bit of science on some of those key molecules that are found in this special Kemin experiment. And that science has looked at the individual molecules to see how those molecules might impact the rate of new neuron growth. I picked one study to highlight today. That was a fairly recent study by Zhuang et al., and they screened 45 natural compounds. So I know that it's pretty small here on the screen, but hopefully you can turn your head and read some of these compounds. I'm sure you're familiar with quite a few of these. These are compounds often used in traditional Chinese medicine. The researchers were screening to see an initial screen of could they actually increase the just a simple cell culture assay to look at new cell growth. And they found two molecules that actually had a significant impact. And one of them was salvinolic acid B. The other one was berberine, and that one actually didn't succeed with the test that followed. So salvinolic acid B was really the only molecule out of all 45 of these tested that could show a viable increase in new cell growth. And so when we know that salvinolic acid B is one of the molecules found in our experiment. The researchers then went on to do an animal study, which is really another important step. And in this animal study, they treated the animals with salvinolic acid B for 21 days, and then they were able to show through a technique using a molecule called BRDU, which incorporates into dividing cells, so it labels a brand new cell. They were able to show that the treatment with salvinolic acid B actually led to an increase in new neuron growth. So what we're looking at here are pictures of the hippocampus from the rat. The small black circles are new neurons, and you can see both qualitatively at the top and quantitatively at the bottom that the treatment with salvinolic acid B did increase the rate, the number of new neurons that grew. Those are the individual molecules. So we wanted to know, what about the whole spearmint extract that we've developed that contains these molecules? So that's what is shown here. We did a study where we took hippocampal neurons and placed them in a petri dish, and then we treated it with a physiologically relevant concentration of that spearmint extract. And what you're seeing on the left, if you look closely, any of the purple dots, those represent complete whole neurons. So those are neurons. And then when you look on the right, when you shine a separate light on there, the new neurons show up. So anything that's in green is a brand new neuron that was formed after being placed in the petri dish. And so we were able to show, again, here qualitatively as well as quantitatively, that treatment with that spearmint extract actually increased the neurogenesis, or increased the growth of the new neurons. So a very exciting result, showing a powerful polyphenol having a really important effect on an important mechanism for brain health. And so with that, we have this supplemental polyphenol experiment. It's called Numintix, and it, as we mentioned, has more than 50 polyphenols and includes those that are important for neurogenesis. So we know that these polyphenols are powerful molecules found in many plants, and here we've shown that spearmint contains some very specific polyphenols that are important for neurogenesis.